Yeah, it's a Morgan 4-4.
It's good from far, but far from good, is it?
Well, look. Yeah, and yeah, so there's a bit of peely paint and stuff, but look, it's got a great interior. That interior is original, isn't it? Look. Okay, so it's lost its stuffing a bit.
Story of my life. What's the SP on this?
It's new at the factory, one family owner.
When was it new? 70s?
1967, yeah. I reckon.
Oh, really? Okay, yeah. Okay. So, okay. Right, okay. Right. One family owner.
Yeah, they took it to the States, had it running around there. Then a mate of mine found it, and we brought it over here.
And that's it?
Yeah, it's sitting around for 10 years, but it's in lovely condition.
Does it run?
Maybe.
What, so you haven't had it running?
Not yet. It's a lovely thing to rag around in.
Yeah, well, yeah. Look, we'll have a think about car. It, and then we'll come back to you.
Sure.
Yeah?
Not
all
a problem.
All right, mate. Great. Thanks, Dino. Shall we have a look under the bonnet? Oh, that looks all right. If we could get it running, we could sell it on as a rolling resto.
Very good idea.
Right, now, let's talk Morgan, shall we, briefly?
Yeah.
Now, look, if we're going to do a deal on a Morgan, we've got to understand, one, we've got to make a profit on it.
Of course.
Right, and two, it could be completely awful.
Yeah. You can make a bid. We're open to offers.
7.5.
No. Could do
8. That's about it.
A little bit more. Another quarter.
8-1 with the Le Mans poster.
Yeah.
Oh, God, no.
8-2 with the Le Mans poster.
250 and yes.
Go on then.
8-250,
shall we?
Right. Okay, go on then.
Thank you very much.
Dino, I have to tell you, we may have got a nice little earner there, or we may have got ourselves a slight problem.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Yeah.
Next morning, back at the shed, Guy gets his first peek at our latest restoration challenge.
Can I just read you the health warning? Okay.
Yes.
Now, Fuzzy and I could not actually have a proper look at it, mainly because there were cars all round it. It doesn't run, okay?
Yeah.
The brakes have had it.
The wheel nuts are loose, so that would explain that someone's been looking at that or something.
Right, OK, so someone's been having a fiddle. But basically, my idea would be, let's get it running, let's get it riding, let's get it stopping, right? Clean it up, and then sell it as a rolling resto.
OK, I think that's a great idea.
There is only one problem.
Yeah.
I'm not exactly your best car mechanic. You vaguely, I think we need some specialist help.
Cue our very own specialist helper, the engine whisperer, Alan Milliard.
He's ready to go. Look, he's put his gloves on.
Nice Morgan.
Now, Millie, obviously, I don't have a clue. I think what we should try and do first is get it started.
First up, a bit of clearing.
Shall I get all this stuff out so you can have full access, kid? Oh my God, that's actually the floor. Look.
It is.
Then we move on to the tricky bit, the engine. This car hasn't been started for at least 10 years and it needs a new battery.
Now, I think this has got some charge in it, lads.
That's gonna be a tight fit, isn't it? You've got to wiggle it in past the brake hose.
The battery fits.
It is rather large.
I'll tell you what, you do get a bad back when you get to our age, Al, don't you?
But some of the electrics appear faulty.
Nothing on the headlights. What about indicators?
I'm looking for the switch.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Got a left indicator.
You know what's really surprising? The indicators work.
Oh, no.
They're normally the things that don't work, aren't they, the indicators?
Headlights don't work, so we'll have a look at that. That might be a fuse.
Before we examine all the fuses, we're going to check the starter motor works.
Here we go.
In goes some fuel, and Guy tries the ignition again.
And again. No spark.
The starter motor works, but the engine won't run because there's no power getting to the spark plugs, hence no spark. Alan double checks for the voltage meter.
There's no power getting to the core, no 12 volt power.
So what?
There could be a secret switch.
What, a cut-off switch?
Yeah.
Alan looks under the dashboard for a cut-off switch, ably assisted by Jellybean, who wants to help lick the problem.
What have you found?
I'm getting up my ear, then.
Get out of the dog. What have you found?
There's a broken connector under here.
Oh, yeah?
It looks like it should go onto the ignition switch.
I think you're going to have to get your dog under control.
No, I think it's great. Al, I can't believe that you don't like it.
I don't mind it, but it's a little... I feel a bit damp.
Next time when he attaches the meter, there's power.
Yes, we've got both.
And a spark.
Yes!
All right!
Hurrah!
We've got a spark, man! That's fantastic! Oh, look, we're halfway there.
Before we try again, we spray the carb with Easy Start, a highly inflammable compound which speeds up combustion.
Ready?
Yeah.
Only one of the engine's four cylinders is firing.
I have to change all the spark plugs.
We change all the plugs. Let's do that.
So we try changing all the spark plugs. It still doesn't work. Then Alan spots something. The HT leads that go into the spark plugs have not been attached in the correct order. We try again. And this time...
Yeah, it's nearly there! That's idling!
Alan, as ever, was right. What a bright spark!
All the plug leads on the wrong way round, but not just on the wrong way round. They're in the wrong place on the distributor.
There you go, you see, man. Hey, look, it seems as though the legend that is Mr. Milliard has got it going.
2 days later, the brake pads are done and the carpets are back from the cleaners.
I've got to tell you, Matt, they've come up rather nice, haven't they?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
It's just a question now, Skiddy. They're finding how they fit.
Well, shall I say, I think we ought to do it. I think some of them will be obvious.
OK.
OK, and then we'll be left with stragglers.
OK.
I think it goes...
OK.
Oh, I don't know. That's perfect, look.
Mint, mate.
I think that one goes in there.
No, I don't know.
Oh, yeah, look.
Mate, take a look at that.
That's all right, isn't
it? That interior now is looking pretty suave, isn't it? OK, if we're going for a 20 grand car, we need to do a lot more. But we're trying to sell it for SPQR, aren't we?
Yes. Yeah?
Small profit, quick return.
Yeah.
10, 11 grand, happy days.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think that's lovely. Do you know what I'm going to do? The sun is out.
Yeah.
Probably not for long. I'm going to call Fuzzer. We're going to go over to Motorhub.
5 minutes later, we pull over and bow to the inevitable.
Here, I'm just going to go here, and we're just going to now get weight.
Okay.
Tick over's a little high.
It is, yeah. Ah, there we go.
Oh. I'm so sorry, man. Aren't you going to help at all?
No. There's a bus in 5 minutes.
There's an emergency!
Right. See you later, Henry.
What do you mean by that?
I'm going to catch the bus.
I don't know what to do.
Well, I can't hang around here. I've got things to do. See you later.
Fuzz? Fuzz? Fuzz?
2 days later, back at the ranch, I've mended the radiator and have even found a punter. My friend Steph and her hubby Graham are petrol heads whose dream is to tour Europe in a vintage car. Let's hope they approve of our work so far.
Steph, seriously, right, obviously it needs resto, but it is a rolling resto, but it's a Morgan, it's 1967,
yeah.
10 grand, it's yours, and I'll have it delivered, because Guy will drive it over. Well, we might trailer it just because, do you know what I mean?
Yes. there's a lot that needs doing.
Seriously, it's
that's
a lovely
gonna
thing.
It's going to take a lot of weekends.
That's the point of it, isn't it?
That's the whole thing. The fun
isn't
is in
it?
Doing it.
She's just trying to haggle me.
Yeah.
What's your best price then?
Nine.
All right. Yeah. Shake it by the hand. Yeah,
brilliant.
Fantastic.
Brilliant.
Steph, look, I have to tell you, yeah, 9 grand. I mean, I haven't made much.
What have I done?
But I don't know, darling, but now it's over to you. That's the result,
yeah,
isn't it? Hey, thank you so much, Steph. I tell you what, man, I promise you, yes, it might still overheat a little bit. Yes, it might need a bit of work. But basically, you've got yourself a bargain.